Hey there, everybody. Sinister here. Another Call of Duty video. Today we're in Modern Warfare 3, where we've been since it was released in November, on the map Downturn. This is a terrible map. I don't think anybody likes this map. The ability to see the enemies don't pop, the garbage on the map is just overwhelming, and there's just no linear. It's more like a mosh pit. Who can win this scrap down fight? Well, in this game, a member of Murder, Tick Tick Boom, makes the mistake and gets of joining solo and gets Infinity Warded. He gets thrown into a game that the team is hopelessly behind, what, 50 or 60 points, triple capped, remains double capped for the longest period of time. Yeah, fast forward a little bit there, what are they down, 120 to 80? The game ends at 200, and so he's thrown into this game severely behind. Have you ever been thrown into a game like this with Infinity Ward? They throw you in. You're behind so far. I was just in a game last week. 185 to 25 I was thrown into a game. You're basically just thrown in to take a loss. By the time you select your class, it's 190. Try to cap one flag, you're game over, right? So it's hopeless. Why they do it, I have no idea. But even in this case, Tick does not get disappointed or depressed or discouraged. Instead, what he does is says, listen, you don't climb the mountain all at once. You climb it one step at a time. And in doing so, actually, I think, produces one of the best comeback Call of Duty total games that I've seen in a long time. I think, so what we have here, we have a talented shooter, talented slayer, who has played against top-level teams and with top-level players. So the talent and ability is there. Infinity Ward throws him in a situation that's almost unrecoverable. And instead of just quitting out or dashboarding, he sticks it out. And even though maybe most of the murder players have win losses of 26 or 25, unbelievable streaks, they don't dashboard. They play it out. And in this case, Tick, what if he dashboarded or got pissed off at Infinity Ward's matchmaking mechanic, he would have missed an opportunity to show what a fine player he really is. Downturn. This is just kind of a terrible map. It's garbage everywhere. Tick just decides to rush around, use available cover and concealment, cap two flags, and control the half of the map, the CB flag. His teammates, for whatever reason, cap A flag, and this triple cap actually allows them to make quite a bit of a comeback, which I think invigorates the team, and you'll see the rest of the team really starts to push harder. And I think that's so important in a game. If you are very far behind, take small steps. And once you are able to get an emotional victory, this is why in our last video we talked about communication. Emotional victories are important in this game. Any amount of momentum, whether it's emotional or kill streaks, whatever it is, will help your team be more positive, be more aggressive, and expectant to win gunfights. You'll win more games if you're positive than emotionally than if you're negative or down or depressed or just discouraged. All in all, unbelievable game from Tick. He was a member of Murder, so there has been a reorganization in many of the teams. Well, the way clans work is several players typically unite together and coordinate and become groups. They break off into segments, and in Murder is no different. Several of the groups began playing competitively together and pretty much found chemistry with one or two players that they enjoyed. Well, as time went on, those players continued to play together and they kind of splintered off. It's just the nature of, you can only play with six at a time, and if you play with the six that you know and trust, you play with that six over and over, so the names just become irrelevant. Many of the murder members have left to form their own group. Whether it's philosophy or style of play, they've formed a group called Ill-Fated. And so you'll see many like Ocular Gumby, Slinka, who many murder members describe as one of the best players in Call of Duty. And Tick, I think, has decided to join Ill-Fated, and several other players have joined this group and have formed their own elite clan. Now, there are other members like Chuck and T-Jack who have decided to form a group run by a YouTuber named Bob Loblaw, and I'll include a link at the bottom. Abomination. So anyway, all that to say is that there's been kind of a reorganization. So when I say murder members, I kind of just say that generally is an umbrella. He's not so much with murder anymore. As you can see, he Moabbed out, made a comeback, overcame the triple cap that his team was racing against and fighting against the entire time. Obviously, the previous team had quit out for a reason, whether it was connection, ability of the other team. So to make a comeback at this level, of this magnitude, really shows not only his talent, but his emotional commitment to trying to win, even when he could have been overwhelmingly discouraged. If you find yourself in this situation, stick it out. You never know. No give up. Don't give up in a game. Fight it out. You never know what you're missing, dashboarding or quitting out of a situation that seems hopeless. Well, no matter how much Infinity Ward tried, it couldn't get the advantage on Tick Tick Boom today. Great game. Hope you enjoyed it. Sinister here. Until next time, I'll catch you on Xbox Live.